Hey everyone, this is your 5-minute daily devotional. Today's scripture verses are coming from James chapter 4 verse 8 and John chapter 15 verse 5. They read as follows. Draw near to God and he will draw near to you. I am the vine, you are the branches. If you remain in me and I in you, you will bear much fruit. Apart from me, you can do nothing. When we are in good times, happy times, times of joy and prosperity and blessing and growth, I'll be the first to admit that it can be a little hard to remember God, to spend time with God when we're in those good times. It's like we're enjoying all the things around us and we just don't put too much of our focus on our time with the Lord. However, when we are in difficult times, times of trouble and pain and heartache and tears, that is honestly a time that we spend a lot of time with the Lord. We run to him, we cry to him, we spend time with him, we lean on him, we ask for his help, his guidance, his direction. And God is so merciful and loving and wonderful and kind and accepting that I honestly don't think he minds that. I mean, he loves us so much that he just will sort of take us whenever, however, whatever, you know, he will just take us however we come to him. He will just open his arms wide up and just sort of wrap us up in them. When I first became a believer, I was just a couple months shy of going through a really difficult season. And honestly, I didn't really know anything. I didn't know the Lord. I didn't, you know church and the Bible and the Word. I was sort of new to all of this, new to my work, my walk with the Lord. And so when I hit that tough season, yes, I cried out to him. I, you know, read my Bible. I was in church. I was volunteering. I was growing in my walk with the Lord, but I was also just experiencing a lot of despair and despondency because I hadn't had a track record with the Lord. I hadn't seen him deliver me. I hadn't seen him do anything in my life. I was very unsure about how this thing would all play out. But step by step, little by little, he did bring me out to the other side and I got to mature. I got to grow. I got to grow in my relationship with him, grow as a believer, a new believer, a new babe in Christ. I got to mature in that area. And I also just kept my relationship with him. I mean, he had walked me through so much. I just kept my relationship in the good times where I still got to know him. I still spent time with him. I still was in his word and memorizing it and studying it and at church and just growing in my walk with the Lord. And it was wonderful because he just became just sort of my best friend. I mean, I just sort of fell in love with him and I felt as though he was already in love with me, but he was just falling in love with me. And it was just kind of wonderful because in that good time, we just, you know, our relationship grew, our love grew. I just fell in love with the Lord and it was absolutely wonderful. It built this foundation and it was really incredible because when I faced another storm, because I had spent so much time with him cultivating a relationship in the good times that when I faced another difficult time, I knew who to run to. I knew who I could count on. I knew who I could trust. I knew that this wasn't his doing, that he wasn't sort of mad at me, that, okay, this sort of does sort of happen in life, and that instead of running away or blaming him, I could run to and just, you know, crawl up in his arms and just be protected and be safe. It just built this foundation that because I got to know him in the good times, that I knew who I could count on in the tough times, and I could rely on him and just stay there right with him, stay by his side. Dear friends, spend time with God and get to know him in the good seasons. I mean, absolutely, when you are in tough seasons, run to the Lord, depend on him, cry out to him. He loves that. He will take us whenever. He absolutely will take us whenever. I worked with this person one time who felt like he couldn't do that because he felt like a hypocrite going to God in the tough seasons. God's not having any of that. He doesn't care if you think you're a hypocrite. God just wants you whenever you want to come to him. He loves you that much. But when we do get to know him in those good seasons, in those, you know, wonderful blessing seasons, it just builds this foundation that we can count on and rely on when we face the tough seasons, which we will all face. It just helps us to see God in a very clear way, in a different way. When we're not, you know, going through storms where our vision is clouded, it helps us to see things clearly that we can, yes, rely on him, count on him, because he's already been with us and he will help us through this as well. In good times and bad, draw near to God and he will draw near to you. Don't separate yourself from him. Stay connected to the vine no matter the times and grow in him. Grow as the fruit he wants to produce, and he absolutely positively will show you himself in the good and in the bad. Lord Jesus, we thank you, God, that yes, we can run to you, God, in the tough times. We can cry out to you. We can lean on you, God. You love that. You want us to, God. You want us to come to you whenever, however, whatever, God, it does not matter to you. You absolutely do love us, God, and we thank you that. We thank you that you love us so much, Lord. But we thank you, God, that we can also get to know you in the good times, God. We can learn our word and memorize scripture and just build that foundation so that when the tough times come, we're ready for them, Lord, because we have a foundation, a sure foundation in you. Help us to remember, God, whether in good times or in bad times, God, just to just spend our time with you, to just get to know you, to just love on you and be loved on by you, God. And that will carry us through, Lord, whether we face the good times or the bad. We love you, God, and we thank you so much in Jesus' name. Thank you guys so much for spending this time with me. If you enjoyed this devotional, please be sure to subscribe to my channel, like and comment on this video. I would appreciate it, and I would love to have you guys. You guys have a great day. God loves you very much. I love you guys. I appreciate you watching. I will see you next time. God bless you.